A very good afternoon and welcome along to this, well, historic Grand Prix, the first ever virtual MotoGP race held in everybody's living room. Well, across the world, we've got people coming from Andorra, Spain, Italy, all to join in the very first hashtag StayAtHomeGP. The first bragging rights, the first honours of the year, the first bit of track action in MotoGP. We've got 10 MotoGP stars forming the grid, 13 world titles, 165 Grand Prix victories between them, so it's quite the field that we're going to have at Mugello. Six laps for them to contest the opening honours, and let's have a word with all of them, starting with the world champion Marc Marquez. Marc, normally you go into most races as one of the favourites, but apparently you've only had the game a couple of days. You've not had that much pre-season testing. How confident are you feeling going into it?
Normally the confidence are pretty high, but in this race, in this case, it's not quite high. So I already know that I will be behind one rider, that is my brother, because he's faster than me. But the rest we will see on the race.
Now, normally we should ask you about your shoulder as well. Controlling the game pads as soon as you get into it in the last laps, is that shoulder going to be a problem at all?
Maybe the fingers can be. No, apart of that, the shoulder is coming better, so I'm ready to.
He's ready to fight for the victory. Well, he says he's going to fight with his brother, Alex. Alex, nerves, I'm sure, are quite high ahead of your debut in MotoGP. Are you ready?
My first race in MotoGP, and it's the first race, so. Well, better than nothing, but yeah, well, looking forward to join a little bit with our college and our mates, and that's it. Have fun a little bit, and also have fun for the people that come.
Are you the favorite, as your brother says?
No. I think more than everybody say that not playing so much, but they know that Teco, Fabio, Maverick play a lot, so will be a tough thing.
So there's some mind games going on. Pecco, your name has cropped up quite a few times as one of the favourites. Even Valentino said, a part of the Riders Academy, that you're the best. Do you feel that you're the favourite going into this race?
I don't know, because yesterday I tried some races in the online, and I crashed a lot. So let's see. But at the moment, I think that can be a nice race for sure, a nice qualifying also.
Fabio, we'll just have a quick chat with you now. Let's just take a look at your game pad first, because I'm not sure whether you've got a little bit of an advantage. What's going on there with that?
This is for Fortnite. For MotoGP is okay, just with this one is not too bad, so let's see what we can do. But it's a normal controller just for Call of Duty or Fortnite.
Okay, we thought we'd better double check, just in case after the race there was no appeals going in to make sure that you're stripped of the victory by using a slightly dodgy controller. So we'll let you go with that one. Maverick, you've been mentioned as well as one of the pre-race favourites. How much practice have you been getting in?
Well, actually, since I knew it would be the race in Mugello, I played the night. I'm still awake from the night. But anyway, there is many riders that are fast. We will see. I'm not used to playing MotoGP. I used to play more on war games. But it will be interesting. Very fun to do something when we are here.
Let's speak to the two X-Star Suzuki guys. Now starting with you, Alex. I can see just to your right-hand side, you've got a little bit of accompaniment, a little bit of support from one of your dogs. Is he going to be there for the whole race? Hopefully bringing you a bit of luck.
Yeah, they are ready too. I'm a bit nervous because I'm not get used to it to play MotoGP. I'm playing more to Gran Turismo. But anyway, let's enjoy this race as Alex Marquez said for the rest of the people that they are in home for this COVID-19. So let's enjoy.
And Joan, you're going to be his teammate throughout the race as well. Are there any team orders? Has Davide picked up the phone and told you guys just to be sensible out there, or are team orders out of the window for this one?
There's no team orders. Yeah, it's a bit strange to make a race here at home, let's have fun, and let's the people have fun with us too.
And let's speak to one of the youngest guys on the riders, youngest riders on the grid, Tektuaq KTM's Iker Lekuona. Iker, having that slightly younger age compared to the other guys, is that going to be an advantage? Normally, it's being inexperienced on the MotoGP grid is a bit of a disadvantage, but the fact that you've grown up with a console in your hands, is that going to help you?
I don't know. It's true, in the 2018 I play a lot, but normally I play more in the computer, like Counter or Call of Duty, so long time I don't play MotoGP. I try yesterday night and this morning before I start, but we'll see. For sure it's enjoy, so we'll see what happens.
And Miguel, what are the tactics going into it? You've only got 5 minutes worth of qualifying, then 6 laps as well, so it's going to be really fast, lots of action. Are there any tactics going into it?
No, not really. I watched the esports races last year, and the races were quite nice to watch, so I hope this one is one of them also. I struggle a little bit this technology, but definitely easier to ride the bike on the track than on the PlayStation.
And finally, Aleix, we've seen you on Instagram and social media, always on your bike every day. Fitness is as good as ever. How's that going to help you in this?
I don't think this is going to help me. believe me that I played this game half an hour yesterday night, trying to prepare everything for today. I have no more time because I'm always cycling in the turbo trainer with my kids, so they are too young. They have advantage, but I will try to catch them up.
Well, let's see how you get on, Aleix. Well, thank you very much to all of you. Best of luck as well. As I say, it's going to be 5 minutes worth of qualifying, only 2 or 3 flying laps for these guys to set the grid, and then a 6-lap race for the opening honours of 2020. Remember, you can get in touch on social media as well throughout all of the events coming up over the next half an hour. So use the hashtag StayAtHomeGP. So let's get set for the first virtual MotoGP race of 2020. There's history to be made.
Go.
All good?
Go.
So I'll be on mute from now on, and I'll speak to you all after the race. So good luck. Speak to you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I'm going to be on mute for the 10 MotoGP riders that are about to go to battle. And I've made the fairly glamorous trip from the presenting studio to the commentary box here in my flat in Barcelona, otherwise known as the short walk from my kitchen to my bedroom, to offer you some live commentary of the first ever hashtag StayAtHomeGP. Up first, we've got 5 minutes worth of qualifying from the iconic Mugello circuit, otherwise known, well, probably as 2 or 3 flying laps within that 5 minutes, so not a lot of time to try and put a good lap together to get a good spot on the grid ahead of the 6-lap race coming up in about 5 or so minutes' time. Just a little bit of insider information for you. Before we went live, just to make sure everybody was connected up properly and everyone's internet was working fine, we did have a cheeky little pre-practice session with Pekka Bagnaia was fastest in. So let's see if the Pramac Racing rider will be able to match that form and that pace once again in this qualifying session. There he is on board with right now, the Pramac Racing rider, the only Ducati on the grid, the only Italian on the grid at his home race as well, so quite a bit of pressure on his shoulders. The MotoGP sophomore as it makes his way down into turn one. We've got our first faller in Aleix Espargaró, already crashed down. I don't think he's even started his first flying lap yet, so not exactly a great start for the Aprilia rider. Here comes Alex Marquez, is it? I believe it is, yeah, the number 73 of Alex Marquez. In fact, no, it's his older brother, Marc Marquez, making his way on his first flying lap. Here's Maverick Viñales. Already talking to each other there, with Alex Rins just asking if there's going to be any long lap penalties for the race, with Marc Marquez immediately saying, no, there's not going to be. Alex Rins replied, we've got it, boss. And then Elaith saying if there are any penalties, then Mark wouldn't finish the race. So already the mind games are at it between each other, already having digs at each other. Oh, there's a big crash for Pecco. So that flying lap won't count for this one. We're now on board with Fabio Quartararo, the only Petronas Yamaha SRT out there. Here he is flicking right now, the double apex right-hander. Mugello, such a super fast and flowing circuit. So important that you try and string a good lap together. One mistake will throw it away here. Here's one of the two X-Star Suzuki guys. Oh, Alex Marquez has gone down now as well. I believe we're on board here with the number 42 of Alex Rins, who's in the top right-hand corner of his screen at the moment. Out to the final corner. It looks as though the X-Star Suzuki rider is going to be the first man to post a lap time in this 5-minute qualifying session. How good is it? It's not a bad lap from Alex Rins. And I'm sure that will be beaten, and it has done straight away. A 144.9 from Maverick Viñales. Takes top spot as Maverick Hutton breaks into the first corner, straight into the back of Joan Mir. I think that's going to be a sign of things to come. Here comes Fabio Quartararo now, over the line. Where will Fabio go? He goes fastest, a 144.2 from Fabio. A super lap from the young Frenchman. He's almost 7/10 of a second quicker already after his first flying lap. Well, we're pretty used to seeing that on a MotoGP race on a Saturday. Fabio Quartararo banging in the fast laps and taking pole position. Here's Aleix Espargaró then on board the Aprilia. He's not particularly confident going into this one. Joan Mir there, you might have heard, just saying that Maverick Viñales, muy rápido, very fast, is Maverick, according to Joan Mir, is probably just caught him by surprise. Maverick saying he's not had that much practice going into this one. But he's already setting some good lap times out there. Second quickest at the moment is Maverick, and read through that second sector as well. Looks like he's improving. Another man that's improving is Pecco Bagnaia here. Didn't set a lap time on his first flying lap after a crash, but this time around he's gone red in sector 2 and 3. Is it good enough for pole position? No, good enough for second. He's only a fraction away from Fabio Quartararo, less than a tenth of a second adrift of pole position is the Italian. We're now on board with number 93, the world champion Marc Marquez, on an improving lap time. Doesn't look like it's going to challenge for pole position. Maverick Viñales goes faster once again there, just to try and hold on to that front row start. Here comes Marc Marquez then, out to the final corner. Is this going to be good enough for a front row start? He's got just under 1.5 seconds to find if he wants to jump onto the front row, and he finds just half a second, so he remains in fourth place. Here's Alex Marquez, according to Mark, faster than himself, obviously younger of the two brothers, so I'm not sure whether that's an advantage in the virtual race. Normally having a little bit more experience helps, but seems like the kids are going a little bit faster so far in his first hashtag stay at home GP. Here's Fabio Quartararo then, red in the first sector. Just waiting for him to come through the second sector. He's got a little bit of traffic in front of him in Joan Mir, who closes the door, and the pair have contact there. And that's definitely going to affect this flying lap from Fabio Quartararo. Again, Joan Mir in the way there. You can see Mir on the bottom of your screen. He's properly getting into this one. Heads going to the left and then to the right, with the controller going with him as well. Fantastic to see Mir well and truly into this hashtag stay at home GP already. The pair of them into the final sector now. Let's just see how good they get on through here. That's Maverick there, not particularly happy with his final flying lap. Ikla Kuona's crashed out. It looks like the young KTM rider is going to hold on to a second row start, although Alex Rins is on a good lap, as is his teammate Miguel Oliveira as well. But let's stay with Fabio Quartararo across the line. It's going to be pole position for the Frenchman. Does he go quicker? Yes, he does. Even faster from the Petronas Yamaha man, nearly a quarter of a second quicker than Pecco Bagnaia. So it will be the Frenchman Fabio Quartararo to start this very first virtual MotoGP race from pole position. What a great lap from Fabio Quartararo. He's going to be joined on the front row by an Italian on an Italian bike. So a good start for Pecco Bagnaia. And there's another Yamaha on the front row as well. Maverick Viñales on the factory machine, starting from third on the grid. You can hear the pair of them joking between each other now. Maverick just saying then that he's been working on the race pace. He said. And that was Alex Rins there, just congratulating his teammate Joan May, saying great teamwork between the pair of them. They've qualified 7th and 8th, they're only separated by 10th of a second as well, so not a lot between the two Suzuki riders at the moment. So here we go then, this is the grid for the very first hashtag Stay at Home GP. It will be Fabio Quartararo on pole position, joined on the front row by Pecco Bagnaia and Maverick Viñales. Alex Marquez and Marc Marquez side by side on row 2, and joined by Ike Lecuona, with Alex Rins, Joan Mir and Miguel Oliveira on row 3 of the grid. And the 10th rider starting from row number 4 will be the Aprilia of Aleix Espargaró. Here we go, the very first MotoGP virtual race is underway at Mugello, and it's a good start from Fabio Quartararo from pole position, but here comes Maverick Viñales on the factory Yamaha. What a start from Viñales, but here comes Quartararo and Alex Marquez trying to get under the inside. It's going to be Alex Marquez to take the lead. There's Quartararo, tucks the front and takes out his teammate for next year, Maverick Viñales. The two Yamahas come together at the first corner, and it's Alex Marquez that gets away at the front, joined by Pecco Bagnaia, who looks to get under the inside. No way through for him there. That's Marc Marquez under all sorts of pressure from Joan Mir. Miguel Oliveira's gone down as well, but it's Bagnaia that's hit the front here in Mugello. Wide though, and Alex Marquez will get back under the inside of him, will they? They're side by side going through the first sector, but it's Alex Marquez, the debutant, that hits the front once again, closely followed by Pecco Bagnaia. Marc Marquez trying to go with these two at the front of the race, but so far it looks like Alex Marquez and Bagnaia have got the pace to try and escape here at Mugello. What a chaotic opening lap. Where is Quartararo now? He's all the way down in 10th place, is he? No, 7th is Quartararo. He's managed to recover. Maverick Viñales, meanwhile, down in 9th. The pair of them started from the front row, but what a disastrous first corner. The pair of them coming together. Quartararo took the front, and he took out Viñales alongside him. What drama. Here comes Quartararo, meanwhile, trying to get under the inside of... Is that Ike Lecuona? It is. He's managed to get past two riders there as Quartararo. He means business here. He's trying to make up some lost time, but back comes Ike Lecuona and Alex Rins as well, but Lecuona's gone down in front of them. They've both managed to escape it. Meanwhile, at the front, there goes Bagnaia under the inside of Alex Marquez. What an opening that this has been in Mugello. Here comes Alex Marquez fighting back straight away, though. Who will have the power down the straight? Alex Marquez tucks in behind the Ducati as he goes past the start-finish line. One lap completed of this hashtag Stay at Home GP, and it's Alex Marquez that leads away, but Bagnaia is harder on the brakes into the opening corner. He's going to run wide though, because there goes Alex Marquez back under the inside, and that's the two Suzukis coming together. It looks like it's Joan Mir that's gone down, and Quartararo's crashed again, and then Aleix Espargaró just runs into the back of him. Absolute chaos here at Mugello. Quartararo's crashed out three times in the space of a lap now. Meanwhile, back at the front, it looks like it's just about settled down. Alex Marquez leading the way, but Bagnaia is all over his rear wheel. It looks as though he's just lost about 2 or 3 tenths of a second though, as Bagnaia maybe made a mistake somewhere. But it's Marquez, Alex Marquez, that's leading the way. Marc Marquez, meanwhile, has been in no trouble whatsoever, as drama has been unfolding behind him. Chaos has been unfolding behind him. He's managed to stay out of it so far and looks as though he's settled into a comfortable third place. Alex Rins is there in fourth. Maverick Viñales starting to recover in fifth now. Joan Mir in sixth, ahead of Ike Lecuona. Fabio Quartararo down in eighth place now, but still ahead of Aleix Espargaró and Miguel Oliveira, who seem to have had crashes themselves.
Yo.
You can see that his teammate Alex Rins going through the kitty litter in front of him. Got it all wrong as Alex Rins there, and it's just going to allow Joan Mir to close in onto the rear wheel of his teammate. Back at the front though, the two leaders are across. They've completed lap number 2, and there's just over half a second separating Alex Marquez and Pecco Bagnaia. Fastest lap of the race, going the way of Alex Marquez, 145.1. We saw that Fabio Quartararo was able to go a second quicker than that in qualifying.
Marc aprende muy rápido, eh?
Sí, esto de que han chupado y la play no me lo creo.
You can hear them talking to each other there once again.
Fórmula 1 no.
Rin's just saying that Mark is learning pretty quickly. Told us at the start of this live virtual race that he only got the game 2 days ago. Well, Alex has just said, goodness gracious me, Marc Marquez doesn't half learn quick on this game. I'm not sure if he believes him that he's only been playing it for a couple of days. Meanwhile, here's Fabio Quartararo. Can he somehow rescue a podium from this position? It looks unlikely now after three crashes in a dramatic opening lap and a bit. All unfolding at that opening corner, looks as though he was just trying a little bit too hard to get past the likes of Ike Lecuona and Alex Rins. The third of the crashes, the only one that wasn't his fault, was when he got absolutely T-boned by Aleix Espargaró. There's Maverick Viñales, just a one crash for him so far. And as a result, he's just managed to recover quite nice. Oh, Ike Lecuona's gone down again. So Viñales has got the claws in. He's trying to close in on Marc Marquez ahead of him. Qualifying's anything to go by. He's got the pace, but he's wide and he's down. Viñales makes a mistake. You can see the frustration from the Monster Energy Yamaha rider there. Slaps his controller out of pure fury. Oh, but Marc Marquez has gone down as well. Well, an opening for Maverick Viñales. He might have thought that third place had gone from him, but there he goes, straight past Marc Marquez. The pair of them crash within half a second of each other. And now it's Viñales that takes control in the fight for the final podium place. Ike Lecuona, another crash for him. Goodness gracious me, Lecuona is crashing so often. And Rins has even just said it then. Rins almost laughing at him, saying that Lecuona can't stop crashing. And he's not wrong as well. Meanwhile, there's Marc Marquez wide. He was on the rear wheel of Maverick Viñales, trying to put him under some pressure, but looks as though Viñales is just starting to escape now in that fight for third place. Meanwhile, at the front, it's still Alex Marquez leading the way. Now 1.1 seconds clear of Pecco Bagnaia. Looks as though a dream debut victory at Mugello is just starting to slip away for Pecco Bagnaia. He's still trying, though, is the Italian. Seeing if he can try and hold on to the pace of Alex Marquez at the front of this one. Here's Fabio Quartararo down in sixth place. He's got Alex Rins ahead of him. Can he make a move on the Spaniard? Oh, the pair come together once again. Front wheel against rear wheel. The pair of them lucky to stay on. Now here comes Quartararo once again. Couldn't get it job done first time around, but this time he manages to just squeeze past Alex Rins. But here comes Rins fighting back. Oh my days, that was close. Rins a proper lunge under the inside. And the pair just about managed to avoid making contact. That means that Quartararo is up into fifth place now. And I think that was Alex Rins taking the car park route. Lecuona again, another crash for the young Spaniard. Been a disastrous first MotoGP race of 2020 for Red Bull KTM Tech Tour rider. Aleix Espargaró just saying, well, where is Aleix? At least he's down in ninth. It's not as bad as Ike, as he was just saying. Aleix saying that he's really bad, and he was even offering his young son Max, saying if he fancied a go instead of him, thinking he might be a little bit better than what Dad's doing at the moment. And he agreed with him, saying he's going to stay with Aleix just to have a bit of fun, because it looks like those down in 9th and 10th, unfortunately, well out of contention now. Well, here we go. This is going to be a real blockbuster clash. We've only got a lap and a half remaining in Mugello. Alex Marquez away with it at the front. Pecco Bagnaia in second. Maverick Viñales in third. But this is a fight that we want to see, to be able to sell out arenas around the world for this fight. Quartararo versus Marquez. It ignited in 2019, but that's a crash for Pecco Bagnaia. It looks like the victory is well out of contention now for Pecco Bagnaia. Meanwhile, Quartararo has made his move on Marc Marquez and he's up to fourth place now. Can the world champion respond to the French sensation? It looks like Quartararo's got the pace to pull away from him. Marquez hasn't been able to respond, which is so unlike Marc Marquez in real life. Normally, as soon as Quartararo made a move on him, bang, there was Marquez making a move right back under the inside. You can see that's Marc Marquez right there, and the gap is already starting to grow, and he's made a mistake there, running wide, which is going to allow Quartararo to escape even further. Oh, Joan Mir's had a crash. He was in contention for sixth place ahead of teammate Alex Rins, but out of the race, and back down to seventh now is Joan Mir. Meanwhile, there is your race leader, Alex Marquez, comfortably in front now after that crash for Pecco Bagnaia. 7 seconds ahead, onto the final lap. He's just got to keep his nerve. And the Spaniard, in his debut MotoGP race, may well take a debut MotoGP victory. Well, sort of, in virtual terms. I'm sure he'll still take it though, starting the season with 25 virtual points. Meanwhile, what battles have we got behind? Pecco Bagnaia does look comfortable despite that crash. Looks like it's going to be a debut MotoGP podium for the Italian as well. Not a bad way to start off the season, especially on home soil here in Mugello. Just a little bit wide on the grass as well. He's still pushing his Pecco. Here are the two Yamahas. Vinales just about clear of Quartararo. I'm sure Quartararo will be pushing to try and take third place away from his teammate for next year. But it looks as though the number 12 Top Gun is just going to have enough in reserve to hold on to it at the moment. And you can see Alex Rins just getting some unwanted attention there from one of his dogs. Not what he needs on the final lap when he's going to hold on to sixth place. So there's Alex just saying that if he crashed twice, he'll be able to catch it for Leclerc. It looks like it's going to be a last place finish for Alex Espargaró, unfortunately.
Yeah.
A crash for Miguel Oliveira there as well on the final lap, but he should be able to hold on to eighth place with Oliveira. Meanwhile, into the final corner comes the Repsol Honda rider, Alex Marquez. He exits the final corner in his debut race. It's going to be a debut win for the Moto2 World Champion. He starts life in MotoGP with victory here at Mugello in the first ever hashtag StayAtHomeGP. Here comes Pecco Bagnaia across the line to take second, and it's third for Maverick Vinales despite a superb final lap from Fabio Quartararo on the last lap of the race. Quartararo puts in the fastest lap of the race. A 144.4, putting Vinales under all sorts of pressure. Even Maverick saying there that Fabio needs to be penalised because he made it crash at the first corner. Fabio holding his hands out, saying it wasn't me, it was the game's fault. What an incredible race that was. So much drama. The opening corner, the pole man, Fabio Quartararo, coming together with Maverick Vinales. It allowed Alex Marquez to escape. He eventually got the better of Pecco Bagnaia in a fierce battle for the lead, and it was a comfortable win in the end. So it's Alex Marquez that takes the victory ahead of Francesco Bagnaia and Maverick Vinales. Fabio Quartararo fourth, having got the better of Marc Marquez in a late dice. Mugello, sixth place. The battle of the Suzuki's going the way of Alex Rins. Just a couple of seconds clear of Joan Mir. Miguel Oliveira and Ike Lecuona in 8th and 9th. And unfortunately, the wooden spoon, 10th place, going the way of Aleix Espargaró. We said earlier in the race, it might have been better if his youngest son, Max, had taken the controller away from him. Well, he certainly couldn't have done any worse. Better luck next time to Aleix Espargaró. The victory has gone the way of Alex Marquez. That was the very first hashtag StayAtHomeGP. Get involved on social media, but let's go and hear what the riders made of it. Okay, so what a race, the first ever virtual MotoGP race. The hashtag StayAtHomeGP has been won in his debut MotoGP race by Alex Marquez. We'll speak to him very shortly, but first off, there's only one place to start. We have to speak with the pole sitter Fabio Quartararo and Maverick Vinales as well. Fabio, you're going to be teammates with Maverick next year. You took him out at the first corner on the first lap as well. What happened?
I break a little bit late and I lose the front. But I don't know if it's me that make him crash, but...
What's the bike? The bike.
Anyway, it's just the game.
So there's no grievance between both of you just yet. You're still going to be friends going into the factory Yamaha team next year.
For sure.
Apologies been accepted. And Mark as well, we need to talk to you. In third place, it was looking like you were going to take a podium, and then you had a crash as well. What happened with you?
No, I'm dead out.
Mark?
Me?
Yeah, we're talking to you. You had a big crash, did you not? In third place, looking like you were going to be on the podium, and threw it away.
Yeah, I knew that my only chance was no crash. And then I start well, and step by step, I get my rhythm. And like in the quad, I start fifth position, I finish in fifth position, so top five in Mugello circuit with a Honda. For me, it's okay. For my riding style, it's fine.
Ah, come on!
Good start to the season, top five. You can build from there. Let's speak to the man that finished third in the end then. Went the way of Maverick Vinales, who, despite the crash on the first lap, managed to pick his way through the field. Good start to the season for you, Maverick, to take a podium, I'm sure.
Yes, I need to get rhythm. Honestly, it's the first time I start well in my life. I start nearly first in the first corner, so very happy actually. But anyway, we crashed many times. Last lap, we can see our Yamaha has the fastest lap with Fabio. Yeah, happy to be on the podium.
What was it like coming back through the fields despite the crash on the first corner? Were there any dangerous moves on anybody? Any lunges under the inside of anyone?
Honestly, I didn't thought to crash, but yeah, I had a crash in the first corner. But then I was pushing, I crashed again, and for me it was difficult to see the podium. But we had a good rhythm, and finally we finished on it. As I said, very happy, and I like to say thank you to Trastevere that gave us the stuff. And we can go a little bit more faster.
Maverick, you did a bit of setup, okay?
Yes.
So you got some help from Trastevere?
Exactly.
Well, that helps. He's not a bad man to get some help from.
As to Fabio also. I think he
really? Okay, so a bit of collusion coming together from the Yamaha guys. Helped them to third and fourth in the end. Second place, a debut MotoGP podium for Pecco. How does it feel to be standing on the podium in the MotoGP class for the very first time, Pecco?
In a different way, but in any case, was nice. I think a nice race. I think we panic, but I make a stupid crash touching the curve in Arrabbiato 2, and I think that the curve is not something. But in any case, we have I'm happy to be second.
Second place for Pecco, and the victor, a debut win in his debut race, Alex Marquez. I'm sure when you went to bed last night, you wouldn't have even dreamt of having a result like that. How does it feel to be a victor in the MotoGP class?
Well, so happy. I knew before the race that I was not the fastest one in one lap, especially, but constantly my target, or my only target for the race. And yeah, we had a good time to go with Pecco in the first lap, and the secret in the Rabietta 2, like he said. So yeah, happy, and also I want to say thank you to Putu, to Maulana, Indonesian riders, that give me the...
So you got a little bit of help from one of the Indonesian riders. How did that help you?
Well, he gave me the setup, and you know, I didn't pass to Mark because he's my teammate, but he's my rival also.
So do the targets for the season change now that you've picked up a win in your first race? Is the championship in reach for you?
I'm looking forward to some next race, next Sunday maybe. So I give that idea for Dorna. But I want to know a little bit before that is a race. You know, I have only 2 days to prepare, so to have a week. Maybe we can choose already one track for rotation and
well, it's 25 points to start the season for you. I'm sure you must be delighted. We'll get the trophy in the post for you, or you can pick it up at the opening round of the year as well. Congratulations.
We can get this point on the normal championship or not?
Well, let's have a word. If you send a letter in, maybe put a tweet out, see if you can get 20 points to start the year with Pecco.
I'm agree.
Well, it's great to have you all, guys. Thank you very much for taking part in the very first virtual MotoGP race. I'm sure you've all enjoyed it, despite some of you having a few crashes, some of you taking victory as well. Remember, all of you can get in touch on social media. Use the hashtag StayAtHomeGP. And fingers crossed, we might have another one coming to you in the very near future as well. But thank you very much for joining us. And hopefully, when is the next race? Hopefully sooner rather than later, Alex. Fingers crossed.
Good.
Thank you very much for joining us, guys.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you.